dear students, once again a very warm good morning to all of you. So let's move for the next point from our lesson, that is sources of food. So today we will discuss about the food chain. Okay, so what is mean by food chain? Let's see. So as we know, in our on our earth, the sun is the main source of energy. Each and every living organism is getting the energy from the sun. But there is a very big difference between the green plants and the other organisms. For example, we can say that the green plants are the only living organisms, those who can utilize the solar energy which we are getting from the sun or which radiated by the sun. But other organisms, other living organisms cannot get that energy or cannot utilize the energy to do their further activities. That other organisms cannot take that energy and cannot utilize it to do their further activities. But only the green plants can use that energy directly, and by using that energy they are making their own food by the process of photosynthesis. Okay, so in this way the green plants are the main leader in the food chain. Because of the food chain or because of the green plants, we are getting the remaining all the animals are getting the food, because the green plants can only trap the solar energy. Why only the green plants can trap the solar energy? Because the green plants is having green color pigment, and the name of that pigment is nothing but what? Chlorophyll. So the chlorophyll is present in the leaves of a green plant. That chlorophyll absorb all the sunlight or traps the sunlight, and with the help of that they can make their own food. That process is called as what? Photosynthesis. So in the food chain, the green plant is comes the first. Okay, the green plants comes the first. That's why we are calling the green plants as a producer. Or grass. Grass is nothing but what? Green plant. The grass is what? Producer. Why producer? Because the grass is making its own food. The green plants are making its own food with the help of photosynthesis process. Now the next one. And while making that food, they are getting the energy. They are utilize that food to get the energy. Next one, we can say that this grass is eaten by the deer, and the deer is nothing but what? Herbivores. Means from the grass, the energy is passed through the deer. Because the deer is herbivorous, obviously it will eat the green plants. Next one, and this deer is eaten by the lion. Means by eating the deer, the lion will get the energy. So in this way, the energy get passed from the grass to deer, deer to lion. Okay. Why green plants or the grass is called as producer? Because the plants are making their own food. The green plants is eaten by the herbivores, and that herbivores is eaten by the carnivores. Okay, so in this way, each and every organism, whether it is herbivores or whether it is carnivores, are directly or indirectly depends on the plant for their food. Okay, directly what we can say, see here, herbivores, they are directly eating the green plants. So it means what? They are directly depends on the plant. But if we talk about the carnivores, it is indirectly depends on the plant. How indirectly? See, because the herbivores is eating the grass, okay, and this carnivores is depends on herbivores for their food. But the thing is that if the herbivores will not get enough amount of the food, then they cannot survive. Okay, and what is the food of the herbivores? That is green plant. And if the herbivores are not present on the earth, then the carnivores will not get the food. Okay, so in this way, all these herbivores and carnivores are depends on each other, and these herbivores and carnivores are directly or indirectly are depends on the animal, are depends on the plants, because the plants are the producers. Also, we can say the one more example here. You can say the grass. So grass is what? Nothing but the producer, because they makes their own food. Grasshopper is the, what is the food of the grasshopper? That is grass. Okay, this grasshopper is eaten by the, this grasshopper is eaten by the frog, and this frog is eaten by the snake, and the snake is eaten by the eagles. Okay, so in this way, all these are the animals which are depends on each other for their food. See here, grass is a producer, grasshopper is there, and that grasshopper is what? Nothing but herbivores. Next one is what? Frog. That grasshopper is eaten by the frog, and the frog is what? Carnivores. Next one. So the frog is a small carnivore, which is eaten by the large carnivores, that is snake. And the snake is a large carnivore which will eaten by the top carnivores, that is nothing but what? Eagle. So all these are the animals, whether it is herbivorous or carnivorous, are directly or indirectly depends on the producer, that is what? Green plants. Okay, so this feeding relationship between the plants and the animals are called as what? Food chain. So this is the feeding relationship, means all these are animals are depends on the plants for their food, and that relationship of the feeding is called as what? Food chain. Okay, so let's see the definition of the food chain. A series of organisms linked together by the process of eating and being eaten for food. Okay, so the food chain can be defined as, it is a series of an organism, it is a one chain of an organism which is linked together, which is combined together. Okay, there is a certain relations between all these. What is that relation? By the process. It is the one type of the process. And what is the process? Eating and being eaten. Okay, eating and being eaten. Okay, means for example, we can say that grass makes their own food, which is eaten by the grasshopper. Grasshopper is a froggy. Grasshopper is the food for the frog. Okay, so in this way, it is the process of eating and being eaten. Means it is a continuous process is going on. Okay, and that process is called as what? Food chain. Okay, eating and being eaten for the food. So this is the proper definition of the food chain. Once again, I will repeat. A series of organisms linked together by the process of eating and being eaten for food. Okay, so this is about the food chain. And today we will discuss about the next point, that is food problem. Okay, that is what? Food problem, which is a very vast problem nowadays we are facing. So as we know, now there is a COVID-19 threat is there, and because of that so many works get stopped, so many companies get stopped, and that's why what? So many people are not getting enough food for their daily purpose. Okay, so that is why it is the regular problem that our country is facing, that is what? Food problem. So this is because what? There is a shortage of the food grains in our society, or we can say in our country there is a shortage of the food. And also one more, a very important reason because of the food problem is that there is a so much poverty in our country. And because of the poverty, what? Poverty means what? So many people are not having enough money to purchase the food, and that's why they cannot get the enough amount of the food. So due to the poverty, they are not getting the enough amount of the food, and these all problems are called as what? Food problem. Okay, so if there is a problem, then obviously there will be the solution. So to solve that food problem, there are the certain things that we have to do. First thing is that we have to use the modern technologies to do the agriculture. We have to use the modern things or the modern instruments to increase the crop production. Okay, so we have to increase the modern techniques. Also we have to use the good quality of the grain, so we will get the more amount of the productions too. Next one is there, we have to store the food stock very properly. Okay, very carefully. If we will store it properly, then it will not get destroyed by the rats and other animals. And the next one is that very, very important, don't waste the food at all. So as we know, if there is any function, parties are there, then we can see that so much amount of the food get waste. Okay, so hereafter, whatever amount of the food is necessary or which is enough for you, that much only you take. If you need it, then again you take. Okay, but don't waste the food, because there are the certain people, those who are not getting the food to eat once in a time also. So hereafter we all will take care of that we will not waste the food. Okay, so this is about the food problem. So in this way today we have complete our this first lesson, that is what, sources of the food. Okay, so this is all about the today, and now I will end my lecture. Next thing or the next session we will continue in the next video for today. Thanks a lot.